Peace. My name is Soul Messiah, and I'm a producer DJ. My name is Soul Messiah. Initially, it's not a hip-hop name. It's actually my given righteous name. Initially, when I was younger, my name was Kid Crush. Because, you know, I would crush all my opponents when it came to b-boying. But around 1988, I got to studying and building. And one of the elders in the community told me, man, a name is everything. You know what I mean? And your name has to mean something. And so my name is Soul Messiah. It's not Soul, S-O-U-L. It's S-O-L, like the sun. And Messiah is Savior or Anointed One. Soul is center, sun, or one. And, you know, we did the whole little naming ceremony and all that, and that's where that began. But I didn't do a hip-hop name because, you know, it's my name. So that's why I use Soul Messiah. And most people just call me Messiah. As a producer slash DJ, I'm in charge of basically creating soundscapes. So my thing is, I'm creating music, and it kind of turns into a picture. You know what I mean? It's like what you hear, like what you see, it makes you feel something. I like what you hear to make you feel something. Thus, kind of the name Soul, Soul Messiah, is I want to be able to touch your soul, but I create soundscapes. I got started around 1983 as a DJ. And as I got a little older and dealing with the culture of hip hop, the production came in because the people that I would be DJing for, they needed music. So we ended up doing a lot of original pieces, and that's when the production kicked in. The production kicked in strong around 1988. That's when it really got serious for me. And around 89, 90 is when I went professional. And that's when the production really started. So when I was younger, I was a b-boy, I was a breaker, and then DJ and producer, and I did graffiti too. I thought that I would be a b-boy for the rest of my life. I was gonna be a breaker, and then I would DJ some, but I would be a breaker for the rest of my life. And in fact, I did break up until about 1995, when my first child was born. And the only reason I stopped, because I had to be home and I couldn't be on the road, with Rocksteady Crew. So, ended up just doing the music more mainly, you know what I mean? And couldn't be spinning on my head as much. I think what makes me different is I'm into tailoring music to artists. For instance, if I wear a size 33 pants, I can't give you a size 38. If I'm gonna make you a pair of pants, it's gotta fit. So I do the music the same way. I will give an artist a skeleton of what I think would sound good with them. After they come in and they write and they do rhymes or singing, then I bring it back and I tailor it to what it is they do. So it's a back and forth collaboration so that it ends up being what I think would be a dope suit, dress, pair of pants for somebody. But just a dope collaboration, which is an actual collaboration. So I feel like that's what makes it soulful. I like a lot of old music, 60s, 70s, soul music, and rock, but mainly soul music. And I loved the pieces that Curtis Mayfield would make or Quincy Jones would make, and it was always a live bass, some guitar, some kind of singing, some live percussion, and I still add those type of elements to the music that I do. So it's always a live bass in one of the songs that I make. I'm always taking a shaker or a tambourine or adding to it and try to add some singing or backgrounds to it. But just a 70s soul vibe added to some boom bap is always great to me. I enjoy the freedom that I get from being able to create music. Freedom meaning, most of us, as you know, have a routine as we have to get up a certain time in the morning, turn in what we gotta turn in, or if we got children, get up, get them to school, pick them up. I'm an empty nester now, so I still get up in the morning, but I get the freedom of creativity, being able to do what I want to do when I want to do it, you know what I mean? And just create art so that people can enjoy it. I love the freedom it gives me. And the satisfaction you get, of course, from when something comes together and somebody else likes it. That helps for people to like it. I do it for myself, but I also do it so that people can feel whatever they feel from what I'm putting into it. If I have something that I think the community could benefit from, then I can inject that. One of the main things I think that is bringing music that they call conscious music and making sure I put that out. Because if anybody knows me, if you don't know, I only do music where the MC or singer is saying something. You have to get something from what it is that I'm doing. And I try to make sure that I add that in. And usually the community, you can tell where we need that. We can tell when we start getting into certain things, we gotta make sure we get this type of music put into our psyche. And so I've been lucky enough, being a DJ and being a producer, to be able to, when I put out music, a lot of people will listen. My peers, other brothers and sisters that put out music, they really inspire me. Black Thought always inspires me. When I hear the rhymes that Ciroc might write or come up with, I be like, you know what? I got something to that. Or just the community of artists, or a dope painter. He or she might have something dope, and you could tell they put their time and their heart into it, and it motivates me to go back and do the same thing in my realm. God Hop developed with me about 98, 99. I was working with an artist. He was just getting started, a brother named Jay Electronica. And we was always building, you know what I mean? And dealing with knowledge itself. And, you know, we was like, you know, it's hip hop, but we dealing with God. Umar Ozdemar, strength, wisdom, and beauty. Or just the entity that people look outside, we always say that it's a part of us. So we changed it from hip to God, and that's where God Hop came from. And then it is hip hop with no fillers, as we always say, no negativity. We're not degrading women, we're not degrading men, and we're not selling no drugs. It's just about upliftment, and that's what God Hop is. My creative process, I'll sit and I'll listen to old joints, right? Or some rock music. Or I'll watch a movie. Like, I'll be watching, I like 70s and 80s movies, so I either be watching a Blaxploitation, as they called it, or one of the 80s movies, and the soundscapes in them, or Kung Fu movies, by the way, soundscapes in them joints is crazy. And that's usually a motivation to me. So then I'll sit down for creating something, and I've given you the example of Ciroc. I work with Ciroc a lot. So we sit and we try to decide, what are we gonna do? What kind of sound are we gonna do? So I have ideas for music, and then she'll have a concept of something, maybe a story from her childhood. And so I try to score that, what I would see. And then I come up with a vibe, you know, either whether it's a sample or something original I play, and a drum. And then, as I said, I would get, well, how you see that? What do you hear on that? She'll add to it, and I'll add to it, and then we'll end up with a dope product. I'm a connoisseur of hip hop, the culture itself. Though I'm just one part of it, which is a producer DJ, I try to embody the whole thing, B-boy and MC and DJ and graffiti. The whole thing, when you think of hip hop, I try to make sure that I'm displaying those energies, you know what I mean? And just the, you know, the culture itself. That's why I see myself as a connoisseur of the culture. Ultimately, man, I want people to be able to take whatever they playing on the internet, or because we back to vinyl now, taking the vinyl, the album that I did, whether it's instrumental or it's with an artist, to be able to put that on and be able to clean your house, chill, some background music, just catch a vibe and feel good. I want to make feel good music for people. And I want it to be able to go down when I'm not here, and my great, 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 great grandchildren can say, this is the music that my ancestor, my great-grandfather, my grandfather made, and it's something that people will enjoy, you know what I mean? Though it is hip-hop, I still believe it's music, you know what I mean? I want people to be able to feel good from what I do. This is Soul Messiah, producer, DJ. This is my voice, and this is my life.